What's going on, Leos? Sending everyone love and light. Thank you to everyone that's liked, shared, subscribed. If you guys have purchased a reading or if you've donated to my page, I thank you. Thank you for being patient with me. I'm feeling a lot better, not 100%. I'm going to get into the energy that's pulling on you now. Let's see who's in your energy. Leos. Okay. Leos. All right, so you have a divine masculine energy coming through. You have someone that you may think of as your divine masculine energy. I feel like this is a person that may have had more than one person that they were dating while they were dating you. This is something that you may have known, may not have known. We have, can you think about polygamy? So this is a person that wants to keep you and wants to keep them as well. They may have approached you with this idea of them saying, hey, you know what? What's coming through for me is someone that's very Afrocentric. And when I say that, I mean someone that is... they feel like the proper way to do things in this here and now 3D land is to mirror what they feel African ancestors did. Okay, so this may be someone that is very pro, you know. So they feel like they have the means, the stamina, the finances to be able to have a poly type of situation. They want someone to agree to this, or they may have presented this to you. I feel like the Leo energy is saying, hell no, this is not what I want. I just want you. And if I can't have you, then, you know, I'm not going to be involved in that type of situation. Although you may have thought about it for a minute, just trying to see if you can handle, you know, the aspects of this. Okay. I feel like because you were not able to handle what would have come if you allowed or even accepted, right? I guess that's the word I want to say. If you accepted the proposal, that's what I'm, yeah, spirit said indecent proposal. That's some bullshit. Listen, if you accepted the proposal that this person was trying to give you, I feel like in your heart you felt like, I can't do it. I just can't. This is not for me. So why put myself in this situation? Okay. This person still craves you sexually. If you guys see this thing on my thumb, I cut myself yesterday, so don't mind that. Anyway, this person still craves you sexually. They still pull on your energy sexually. So if you guys wake up and you feel, you know, that you could be aroused in any way, it's because this person, you know, has been manipulating your energy. You may think about them a lot too. This person touches themselves when they think of you. You may also touch yourself when you think of this person. Just put the energy wherever you need it to be. You guys know I keep it a buck. Yeah. Someone here is riding past the other person's house, and I think that you may not live too far from this person. You may live in the same state, same city, something of that nature, and this person may come by just to check and see if you've moved on in your life. They're trying to get their courage up to come and talk to you because they want you to really agree to the terms or agree to their proposal of being in their life. This is someone that doesn't want you to not be in their life. They really want you to be in their future, but it's on their terms. Okay. So that's what's coming through. Bottom of the deck is, I want to marry you and be yours forever. Okay. This is a person that's trying to do a sister wives type of situation. Thank you, Spirit, for coming through and giving me that. So I don't know who this is for, but let's continue. I'm going to do short reads today while I continue to recover. Thank you guys for your patience. All right, so let's see. Okay, so you're coming through, Leo, as someone that's mostly celibate, right? And if you are doing anything, you are basically, touching yourself, doing those types of situations. But you have a lack of desire to be out here in the world, or a lack of desire of meeting anyone new right now, because you're still into physically this person that's coming through in this reading. Okay. Abuse. You're also a person that may have went through a lot of abuse in the relationships. This person may have come in at a time and gave you a certain type of gentleness that you were not used to. This is why you're so connected to them. The way they did things, the way they made you feel, was like no other. And just as quickly as it started, it ended. So the cutoff, or the, I feel like the withdrawal, okay, symptoms that you're going through are continuous with this situation, because you didn't get any closure. You didn't get to go through the healing stages that you needed to go through. I think you've just been in limbo for quite some time. Somebody here I'm talking to, you've been in a state of not being able to move forward because you're still connected to the past. All right. And even though this person may not have physically abused you, right, you're learning that the emotional side of things that they put you through, may be more, how can I say that? Whoever I'm speaking to has been physically abused, has been verbally abused. However, this emotional abuse is what's bothering you the most with this person, okay? You're not understanding why this is something that you can't shake or can't break from, is what I feel, okay? And it's because, and I'll get to this card in a moment. It's because this person awakened feelings in you that you had never experienced before. And you might have felt like, hey, this is my person, the end all be all. I finally have what I need. And then they switched up on you in some way. So the devastation, thank you, Spirit. That's what I'm feeling. The devastation that this person caused in your life is what causes you to not be able to let go of them, as well as them not letting go of you, because they are sorry for what they did, but they will continuously do the same thing. Because even though they're sorry that you didn't, okay, they're sorry that you didn't accept them for what they were presenting to you. That's what they're sorry for. Right? Like, I'm sorry if you don't understand me, but I'm not sorry for how I treated you. This is the energy that's coming through. So someone needs to know that this person is still stuck in their ego. Thank you, Spirit. This person still goes through, different challenges. They're stuck. This is who they are, right? They're not trying to change. They don't want to change. For someone to make different choices, they have to want something new. And this person feels like everything that they want is what they should want, right? So they feel like they're doing things the right way, and they are stuck, right? They do things out of fear. When they're alone, they do have negative thoughts. When they're alone, they realize how alone they are without you, because whatever element you added to their lives, Leo, it mattered to them as well, just as the situation and the connection mattered to you. Okay, so but this is also a person that feels like, no, I don't need just one, I need more than one. Okay, so Two of Swords is here, right? You guys are at a stalemate, you guys are not going forward, right? You were sitting on the fence for a while because you might have been trying to figure out if this is something that you can handle. Like I said, can I do this, right? And you were at that crossroads, and you had to be absolutely honest with yourself and say, yeah, no, this is not something I could do. This is not something I want to do. And you made that difficult decision to go forward without this person. However, it's very stressful still. It's very hurtful still. Okay. but you're still stuck in this spot because going forward means that you have to totally let go of the possibility of you and this person. And going forward means that you're absolutely ready to be in another relationship. The fear comes in you guys are saying, I don't want this to happen to me again, or I'm afraid to get attached to someone that could possibly hurt me like this again, right? This person here that's attached to your energy, pulling on you, is torn between you and multiple relationships, okay? So they still have love for you, but they do have love for other people as well. So they really have a divided loyalty. They're not giving loyalty to just one, okay? So this is that energy that I'm seeing, okay? So we have Six of Cups. That nostalgia is there. That love is there, right? This is somebody that you want a reunion with. This is someone that wants a reunion with you, right? This person is always a lot of fun, very playful, very youthful, maybe in great shape as well. You know, may have been an athlete for some of you. I'm getting an athlete of some nature. But this is also a person that's very childish, very immature, and they want things the way that they want them. They don't really see the vision of life the way that you do. And this is a person that's always going to be connected to their roots because they haven't done the healing and the ego damage that they have to themselves, right? I feel like there's childhood wounds here. I feel like there's a past relationship or two that may have really impacted this person to where they feel like they always have to have a backup. This is a person that cannot be single. This is and when I say that, they can't be alone, right? They always have to have an option. So because of how they were hurt, they decided to always have a backup plan, which doesn't help other people that are trying to be around them, to get to know them, to love them, right? They're not even accepting the love from people, but they're accepting the intimacy, okay? So for some of you, you're trying to make a decision and the answer is maybe from spirit, okay? They're giving me a maybe here. You also have, you know, the need or the want to maybe return to this relationship, or they want to return to you because they feel like, you know, you guys are the root, or you feel like they're the root of who you are. You may have had that type of spiritual connection with this person to where you felt like, you know, this is my other half. For some of you, it's not going to be for all of you, but the connection is real. With someone here, you need to work on your root chakra, okay? Just have to put that out there. You may have to do that root chakra work. Excuse me. You also have the third eye chakra that may be blocked right now that you need to work on. Okay. If you don't know how to do this, just Google third eye chakra, root chakra, in frequency music, you know, on YouTube. And then just let it play while you're sleeping. That'll help you as well. So the heart chakra is blocked because you're afraid of going forward and actually physically turning your back on the potential of this love coming back to you. On their side, they don't ever want to let you go because they feel like you belong with them, right? So, you know, their heart chakra is yearning out to you. Your heart chakra is blocked because you're stuck, okay? So I just need someone to understand what I'm saying. We have Scorpio energy coming through, and we have Libra energy coming through. For some of you, these could be things in your chart. These could be things in their chart. We also have moon energy coming through. This is feelings or instincts that you guys are trying to decipher, trying to figure out some things, right? There's a lot about this person that you could not figure out. And we have the sun energy, right? Your conscious mind and the ego, right? This person is dealing with their ego side. So the sun energy is coming through as well, okay? Spirit said, look at the bottom of the deck 1 minute, and then we're going to end this. Yeah, we have Eight of Cups, okay? Spirit is saying, let it go. If you're asking if you should move on from this person, right? This is something that you should do. If you are asking yourself if you should stay with this person, the answer is no from the universe. I have to give it to you, okay? Somebody needs to work on your solar plexus chakra as well, right? This person may have abandoned you in ways where you felt like they walked away, or they may have disconnected, or may not have been as emotionally connected to you. You may have reached a point where you're like, I just don't know what to do. And now Spirit is wanting you to be in self-discovery mode, to look deeper within yourself, to understand what it is you truly want and need, and not feel like everything or everyone is going to disappoint you in the future. I think this is where you are. Right? I think someone's heartbroken still, you know, and you haven't recovered. All right. So the moving on is what Spirit wants you to do. They want you to be happy. They want you to feel love. You are worthy of that. I don't know who I'm talking to right now, but they want you to know. Okay. You also have Pisces energy coming through here. It is Saturn, right? Your responsibility and discipline. Responsibility is to yourself. Discipline is for you, right? To get yourself to a place where you're able to receive the type of love that you deserve. But it first happens when you let go of this energy, okay? And don't let this energy continue to pull on you. Make sure you're doing your spiritual baths, okay? So I'm sending you guys love and light. Y'all take care.